We get a lot of questions here at MCAT, and one of the most common questions we get is, why are you guys running empty buses? Or why are the buses running with only just a few passengers? Well, there's a simple explanation for that. It's important to note here that last year we carried almost 1.5 million people on our buses. And you don't do that by running empty buses. In fact, 1.5 million is about an 8% increase from what we carried the year before. And that's the highest increase from any transit agency here in the Tampa Bay area. Things change over the course of the day, and yes, in the mornings, in the afternoons during peak hours of traffic, you will see full buses. But in the middle of the day or at 7, 8 o'clock at night, you're gonna see buses that aren't full, just like traffic. The peaks and valleys in our ridership, it's similar to the way we design roadways. We design roadways for their peak capacity. Similarly, that's the way our service operates as well. We've got peak hours when we get a lot of riders, and then there's certain times of the day where those routes are not gonna have a lot of passengers. We only operate about 23 buses a day. So with those 23 buses, we're carrying 1.5 million people. There's certain times of the day where those buses are full and they're standing room only. There's some instances where you'll find some routes that are always full. If you think of the trolley that's on the island, or you think about our US 41 service, the Route 99, those buses generally have lots of passengers. Those are buses are considered our core network of services. You ask yourself, why don't we use smaller vehicles? Now there's two reasons for that. Imagine the Route 99 or our AMI trolley operating with smaller vehicles. That would require us to put a lot of capacity, which equals to a lot of vehicles out on the island or along US 41. The larger vehicles, they're better on the maintenance. They're designed to last 12 years and operate for 500,000 miles. We don't get that kind of lifespan out of the smaller vehicles. So you can see how the replacement cycle works here. We have equipment on the buses that counts passengers. Everybody that gets on and everybody that gets off, we count. And we can organize those ridership counts by route, by the trip of the day, and even drill down by stop. We are working to encourage more people to ride our buses, and we're doing that in a variety of different ways. Really, it comes down to three things: improving service, improving technology, and adding infrastructure out in the field, bus stops and bus stop amenities. So if we talk about service, it's really the core network. If we can put more frequent service on those core network routes, it really resolves a lot of people's transportation issues. Technology. We've added real-time bus information to our service. So what does that mean? You'll know where your bus is. By using a phone app, by looking at the website, by looking at digital display signs that we now have at stations, or you can look on your phone and see where your bus is as you wait at a bus stop. We've also made it easier to buy tickets. We have a mobile ticket application. So in other words, you don't have to go to the booth to buy your ticket. You don't have to have exact change to pay for your fare when you get on the bus. You just buy it via your phone and you show that mobile ticket to the operator and you're off on your ways. The last thing we're working on is making sure we have amenities at bus stops. We live in Florida, it's hot, it rains, people want to be able to sit or they want to be sheltered from the elements. We're working hard to make sure that we have those amenities at our bus stops so that people can wait in the shade, so that people can wait while seated, waiting for their bus. The most important part of this is to encourage folks to come use our service. There are people riding the bus, it's there for everyone's use. We got technology on the vehicles, we got ways to pay for your bus passes, we're building infrastructure, we got good equipment on the road. There's lots of people riding the service and it is an easy way to travel. So I would encourage you to try MCAT. We've done a lot of things here over the last few years to try to make it easier for everyone to use our service. And hopefully all these things attract more of you to ride our buses.